Good morning, eNeil79 here for the Survivalist Mindset. The first thing you'll probably notice is that I am not out in my workshop. I am actually here in my kitchen, so you'll have to bear with me. We're using the webcam today instead of the camcorder. The picture quality's off. I apologize for that. Today we're going to be doing a short review of the KaBar Warthog. Now, the reason I got this knife in the first place is because I lost my main field survival knife, if you want to call it that. I've never really been a fan of the term survival knife, but it was a fixed blade, heavy duty BK2, if you're familiar with those. No longer have it, so I wanted to find a replacement. I bought this Warthog, and I'll share it with you in just a moment, but I don't think that it's going to be a good replacement. It's probably going to be a good collector knife. This is the made in the US version that is no longer in production. KaBar has reintroduced the Warthog to its lineup. However, it is made in Taiwan out of AUS6 steel, I believe. The handle's different. The entire quality of the knife is different. This is the original, made in US, out of 1095 Krogan. We'll open her up and I'll give you a look. The sheath is a Kydex sheath. It's if you're familiar with any of the KaBar Kydex sheaths, it's just like the rest of them. It's got a retention strap here, a retention strap here, and a retention here. So you pull down. The guard actually gets caught in here so it doesn't fall out. It does have lashings and grommets all over, so you can easily strap this to some molly gear or wear it on your belt, however you choose to do that. The knife itself is where my issue is. Quality, well-made KaBar, of that I have no doubt. This has the Kryton handle, which is same size as a full-length KaBar, 4 1/2 inches from the guard to the pommel, 5 1/2 inch blade from the guard to the tip. You'll notice it is wide. This thing is very wide. I've actually been made fun of by a friend or two, and they call it my pancake flipper. It's got a very nice belly. I suppose it would probably be good for skinning, but as far as a bushcraft knife, not so much. The main reason, well, there's multiple, but one reason, this guard sticks up too high. If you're holding the knife this way and you like to get some thumb leverage, it's very difficult because of this guard to get a comfortable thumb grip so you can do some carving or anything like that. This gets in the way. Another thing, if my webcam will pick it up, let's see if I can get this real good. You see how it's thick back here and it gets very thin towards the tip. Very thin. There's actually this secondary angle here that could almost be sharpened. So the main thickness of the blade is only this far. If you were to try to baton with this, I would be afraid you would break the tip. Again, probably a very good skinner, not a very good wood processing, camp chore style knife. It's just, it's not going to work for what I bought it for. I have seen online these go for quite a bit of money because they don't make them anymore. Not the U.S. Here, let's see if I can get in here. Made in USA. KaBar, only in New York. The upgraded model, if you want to call it that, the new release model, the blade shape remains the same. It is no longer 1095 Krogan. Like I said, it's AUS6. The handle is very different, and it does not have this guard sticking up here. Actually, it comes and curves down. It's not your typical round KaBar handle. Is it a good knife? I don't know. I can't attest to that. However, this will probably sit in my shelf until I find someone who wants to trade knives with me. I do have a helper coming up here. I do have a new knife on order that should be here anytime now. I went ahead and I ordered the Ontario Ranger Bush Series Afghan knife. It's got my carter handles and whatnot. And that should, as soon as that comes in, we'll do an unboxing and review video, and hopefully that'll work out. I was going and intending on taking this out with me on a winter camping trip I'm going on. I'm going to make some videos for you guys out there, and I was going to maybe do a little demonstration. However, I think this knife is better served as trade bait, barter, if you will, because it's not. I can just tell you from holding it, from looking at it, it's a quality knife. It's just not going to work for what I want it to work for. And rather than taking it out and tearing it up, I think I will just maintain it in its new original condition and use it as barter bait for something that may be more useful. That's part of the survivalist mindset, guys, is finding use and value in things that you maybe have no use or value for or with. Someone else may. For a long, long time in human history, that's how things got purchased. That's how you got what you needed, is you traded with someone else. And with the ever-shrinking value of our dollar, there's a lot of that going on. Just look at Craigslist under the barter tab. Go to any gun and knife show, and you'll see. There's a lot of bartering to be done. And there's a gun show coming up this weekend that I am going to be going to, and I will get back with you with an updated video on that, see what I can come up with, see what I can trade this for. That might make a good video, a good barter video, to see what I can make this into that will be useful for me. Again, the KaBar Warthog, you can't find them online for $100 anymore, not the original ones. I found this at a surplus store near here, $69.99. Happened to be new old stock still on the shelf. Took advantage of it. We'll see what I can turn into. Hey, until next time, guys, just remember that the only certainty in life is change. God bless, and I will see you all again very soon. Thanks.